maybe. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. As always, thank you so much for being here and sharing your time with me. I really, really appreciate it. If you can hear the noise of cars passing by, I'm sorry. I tried to distance myself as much as I could, but I think this is gonna have to do. Before I start this video, which is a very exciting video for many, many different reasons, I want to thank the sponsor of this video, which I never even thought I would ever utter those words. What a bizarre concept, but that is Ana Luisa. It's a jewelry company, a beautiful jewelry company at that, and they kindly reached out to me and asked me if I wanted to select a few pieces and show them to you and talk about them. So here I am with the pieces, talking about it with you. And I can't be any more excited because I've been subscribed to Ana Luisa, like their emails, for a year. So when I saw the email, I thought it was just like a new item had dropped or a sale was going on. And then it took a second for my brain to clue in that the email was specifically for me. Very bizarre, very strange, but I'm honored to work with them. They're such a wonderful company. I'm a huge, huge fan. And the pieces that they sent me, which is this beautiful ring, oh, it's stuck in my hair. This beautiful necklace and my pearl earrings. I don't know if you can see them, but they're beautiful and I'm in love with them. And I'm so, so thankful to Ana Luisa for doing this. What? That's so cool. Anyway, I'll insert more clips of the pieces that I think are absolutely stunning. This one in particular is the silhouette of a body, and it just makes me so happy because the human body is beautiful in all its shapes and forms, and it's a constant reminder of that, so it makes me very happy. Anyway, thank you, Ana Luisa, from the bottom of my heart. I will leave the links in the description to the company, to the pieces that I got. The rest of this video is going to be a little road trip that I did with a dear friend of mine named Juniper. We went island hopping here in BC, the Gulf Islands, and it was a splendid time. I am such an obnoxious island girl and I love every minute of it. So I guess back to my roots with the travel video and then morphing it with some book content as we read Normal People by Sally Rooney, which I hadn't read in a year and a half almost, and the arc of her newest one that's being released on September 7th. So without further ado, let's get into it. Say hello. Hopelessly devoted to you. Thank you.
point, too.
Yeah, it's true. I can pour it on mine to make it equal.
No.
Oh, interrupting the video midway through. Clearly I am no longer in a beautiful Gulf island. I am back at home, but I realized that I didn't do very much talking in this whole video because I was just getting pretty little snippets of my road trip, and I thought I would do a little talking video to briefly, but maybe not so briefly, discuss this book, but Sally Rooney more in general. I know Sally Rooney a few months back was being highly discussed. She, for some reason, was a very dichotomous topic. Some people either loved her or some people apparently hated her, which I didn't realize until I kind of gave my attention to this discussion that was going on. Some people don't think she's a good writer, but I fall under the category of those that really enjoyed her writing. I think for me, what I appreciate so intensely about her is her ability to brutally accurately depict the simplicity yet the complexity of human interaction. Did that make any sense? Perhaps not. How can I explain that? I guess the premises of the premissi of normal people and conversations with friends are relatively normal. It's two individuals that are involved in some way, whether they're dating or have a deep friendship, and then it's how they maneuver their love life, right? Similar situation on this one. And it's so brilliant that a seemingly banal topic such as that, she writes it in a way that I find very visceral. For example, a year and a half later, after reading Normal People, even before the reread, I still would feel like in my gut how unsafe I felt when I read Normal People, specifically the scenes where she would describe, what are the names? Why did I just forget her name? I fully just forgot the main girl's name and Normal People. Oh, I hate when that happens. Regardless, the toxic relationship she had with her mom and her brother was so well described that I would feel physically unwell while reading those pages, and that feeling lingered with me a year after reading it, and I think only a good writer can achieve that feeling in someone. I also love the fact that she is an Irish writer, and Ireland as a whole means a lot to me. I have met some really incredible Irish humans, and the way that she writes, the vocabulary is very accurate, and I feel like I can hear them and
the places that she describes. I've been there. So I also do think I have more of an emotional attachment to the story than some people may, or just to all of her stories in general. But I do think it's really incredible the way that she's able to write, I don't know, day-to-day relationships in a way that are very poignant. Written in the third person, my coworkers are always talking about what kind of writing it is, but it's third person, I don't know, third person something. And then there's also emails that are being sent between the two characters back and forth. And I'm here for it. I'm here for a good email correspondence. I love the wit, love the banter. I enjoyed it. I thought it was good. I definitely will read it once again. I don't know if I'll read it right away. But once it comes out, so that we can all discuss it openly. Once you can all get your hands on this. So that's all I will say. If you didn't like the other Sally Rooney books, I still think you should give it a go. Maybe this one will be your cup of tea. And similarly, if you do like Sally Rooney, I'm sure you'll love this just as much. So, okay, back to the video. Thank you.
Perfect, I found my set.
Me.
Hi, Bubba. What's your name? What's wrong? Hi, sweetheart. Hi, Bub.